This is 5 questions. This video is going to focus on 5 questions from exponents and logarithms. These are the 5 that you see, and if there's one in particular you want, then just go ahead and fast forward to it. Otherwise, you can just watch the whole video. Let's look at that first one. Solve for x. You will notice that x is an exponent, so we're going to have to treat this a little bit differently. But normally what you would do for a problem like this is you'd want to isolate the term with the variable. In this case, the term with the variable is a base, is an exponent, so the base is probably what you want to focus on. Let's look at it in a different light. Let's restate this in a slightly different way. This first term here, let's rewrite that as 3 to the x power and then squared. Also, you'll notice that I'm putting this part in parentheses. You'll notice that we have 3x twice, 3 to the x twice. And, you know, that's a little weird to look at, so let's look at it a bit differently. Let's look at it so that, if I were to take these out and just put y there, you'll see what you get here is an ordinary quadratic that you can factor. Let's examine the problem like that, and then also look at it with the original side by side, so that way you can see the comparison and how we treat this. When you look at this first one, you would factor. That would be y minus 5 and y plus 2. You'll notice that I kind of did the same thing over here, only instead of y, I'm writing 3 to the x and 3 to the x, because recall, that's what we originally had here and here. Now you can do it either way, whatever makes it more easy for you to complete the problem. Just remember that at the end, after we would use zero product rule and get y equals 5 and y equals negative 2, you need to replace back the 3 to the x power, because we're not finished if we just have this, because that's not what we originally had. Remember, we're solving for x here, not just for y. So what do we do? Well, if this were it, you'd be done, but here, remember, we want to solve for x. Since x is an exponent, what you want to do is you want to free up that exponent, and the way you do that is to take the log of both sides of the equation. Let's look at that first one. If you were to take the log of both sides, we'd wind up with this. Now keep in mind, I'm just writing log here, but let's not forget what the base should be. The base should be the same as this one, and the reason why is because it is the 3 that has the exponent of x. And the reason for that will become even more clear momentarily. Okay, now you'll notice that we have an exponent now with a logarithm. One of the properties that we can use for logarithms is that we can take this exponent here and we can relocate it as a coefficient. So let's go ahead and do that. And there we are. And you'll notice this part here, we have the log of a value with the same base. When you have that kind of situation, this entire term is equal to 1. So it's really what you got is x times 1, which is essentially x. All right, so then there's our answer, at least for this first part right here. Now let's look at the second one. And let's keep in mind that this is one of our answers. Now looking at this second one, you might see that this is actually an impossible problem to do, but we'll kind of go through anyway, use the same strategy, and that is, we'll want to take the log of both sides. So when you take the log of the left side and the right side, this is what we get. And you'll notice that on the right-hand side, we're taking the log here of a negative value, which unfortunately is a no-no. This value here has got to be positive. It can never be 0, can never be negative. You can only take the log of positive values. Because of that, that gives us no solution. So our first answer, as it turns out, is really our only answer. And if you were to write just the exact value, this would be good enough. If you were to use a calculator, that would be your answer, in that you would use a change of base. You would take the log of 5 and then divide it by the log of 3. And the reason why we would have to do that is because your calculator cannot work with base 3. It only works with two different bases, base e, which is the natural log, and then base 10, which is the common log. Okay, solve for x of this logarithmic equation. When you get a problem like this, you'll notice that on one side you have two terms that have a logarithm. So what you'll want to do is you want to make that just one logarithm. In doing so, the first thing you want to mind is whether or not there are actually any coefficients in front other than 1. You can see there's nothing to worry about here, but here we have a 2 in front of our logarithm. So what you'll want to do is, like what we have for this property, that coefficient becomes the exponent of what you're taking the log of, as you see here. We're going to take this 2, and we're going to relocate it right there. Okay, now that that's done, we can take these two logarithms and combine them. There are two properties that we can use. One is the product rule, and one is the quotient rule. It just depends on what you have. Since we are subtracting here, we're going to be using the quotient rule, in that if you're taking one logarithm and subtracting a second one, that simply becomes the logarithm of the first one divided by the second one. So we're going to take this first quantity and divide by the second quantity. Keep in mind that this only works if you have the same base, and we do. Both terms have a base of 3, and we want to keep that here when we do the combination. Sometimes people forget the base. Okay, now that that's done, what we're going to do now is we're going to take this thing and we're going to rewrite this in exponential form. Typically, when you do exponential form, you take the base of the log, whatever it is, and that's simply going to become the base for your exponent. So instead of small 3, though, it becomes big 3. In other words, this base, which was small, grows. And then what happens is that this part here and this part here, they will end up switching places, so to speak. So what happens is this. You're not going to have this whole group here right above your 3. Instead, you're going to have the 2 there. And instead of equaling 2, it'll equal this entire quantity. So there you are. And when you've done this, by the way, your logarithm is now gone. Okay, let's go ahead and solve this. Let's get rid of this denominator here. We're going to take this and multiply both sides. And when you do that, that allows us to reduce this out. Now you'll notice what we have essentially is a quadratic. And typically with quadratics, what you want to do is you want to set one of the sides equal to 0. So let's take this group here on the left and let's subtract it to the other side. And then from here you can solve either by factoring, if you can, and then if you cannot, then you would use the quadratic formula. As it turns out, this one factors. Then set each group equal to 0 using the zero product rule, and then we solve. And that's really it, except for one thing. You'll notice that one of our answers here is negative, and we have to cross this out. The reason being is because if you had replaced negative 1 back into the original equation, either here or here, you will see that you'll end up taking the logarithm of a negative value, which means that this answer has to be ignored. So that's our answer. Okay, that ends this first part. Now move on to part 2.